Who was the biggest puncher you ever faced?
Ezra Sellers.
The hardest fight you ever had?
Oh, it's a toss-up between Hakeem Taffay and Ezra Sellers. And I would say Hakeem Taffay.
What motivated you the most to get through the tough battles you faced in your career?
The will to win. That's what got me. I want to win, I didn't want to lose. So I think that's motivation itself.
When you reflect on your career overall, what are the first memories that appear, and which are the ones that pass through your mind the most?
Well, beating David Haye, I think that's a highlight, because he was 23 and everybody, even my wife was worried for me. So that's to reflect. And of course, reflect on winning the world title. I mean, obviously they're the high points, you know. Yeah.
In hindsight, what would you have done differently if now looking back?
I think I was selling myself more. I never sold myself much. I wish I'd done that. But, you know, I wanted to do that, but I feel like I wasn't being real to myself. I wasn't being real to people if I start changing my colours, you know, start talking a lot of rubbish. I don't know if the public believe in these rubbish, what these boxers talk about. I like to think that the public really come, that you can really fight. They come to see you fight instead of talking about the trash talk. I hate trash talking. But if the public seemed to love it, I think I would have changed that and talked trash talk. But at the time, would they believe me? Well, I wish I started how I should have started my career that way. You know, talk a lot of trash and hope the public believe it. Sorry, public, I know you're more intelligent than that.
Okay. In 40 fights, you had 6 losses.
Yeah.
Out of them, which ones do you not accept, you know?
I felt like I lost 3 fights. I don't accept the Johnny Nelson fight, that I actually lost that one. I don't accept the Franco Rocchigiani fight. And I think it's one more. Of course, the Ralf Rocchigiani fight, I dislocated my shoulder. So I don't think I generally lost. But the other 3, yes, I lost them. I put my hands up.
What information would you give to a young pro just joining the game?
I think they got to talk, more talkative, bring charisma, I can't put it out, the way you're going to have to do that, charisma to your scene, to your scene, you know. You've got to sell yourself and you're going to make people come and want to watch you. So, and you're going to be excited, aren't you? You're going to have to talk to trash talk, I'm sorry.
How has boxing changed now from when you was fighting?
I don't know if it's, how much it's changed. I've not been in that much to realise how much it's changed. I feel like if you have to change, you've got to sell yourself. I think that's what I find. If you don't sell yourself, you're not going to be a household name. Again, I'm repeating the question, you've got to sell yourself, you know.
What do you miss most about the game?
Making some money. I need to make some money. I won't say I loved fighting. I won't say I loved it. It was a living. It was a job. I didn't fight purely for money. I fought for belts. So, without one, without the other, it just didn't work with me. So,
do you still follow boxing now?
I follow boxing. The reason I probably follow boxing because of Ensley, who's got fighters, I'm involved with them, and I think it keeps me there. Obviously, the main fights I do follow, I like to watch them, so yeah, I'm still keeping my foot in there, yeah.
Which British boxers at the moment impress you?
British? I don't have anyone impress me at this present time. I watch Carl Flock and all that. Boxing, like I said, I only watch the championship fights. I wouldn't say someone's jumping out of me and said, yeah, I must go and watch it. So I'm not that excited about it, you know what I mean?
You've been retired 9 years now, Carl. Uh-huh. What have you done in that time?
9 years? Not a lot. Well, what I'm doing now, I'm teaching the public to boxing and keep fit and that's what I'm teaching, and I've been doing that for, I can't believe I've been doing that for 9 years. Oh, what? No, I'm not sure I haven't. No, I think, I don't know what I've been doing. I think I've been here for like 4 years. So I don't know what life I've done for 5 years before that. So I don't know.
Does the urge ever leave you to want to put the gloves back on again?
No, I think I would say it doesn't leave, because I felt like I'd gone out on a, at the wrong time of my life. So I suppose I do feel it is, I would want to put the gloves back on, because I felt like I had plenty left in the tank, if you can say. But because I've lost my size now, I'm under fighting weight, I'm like a 14 stone, and I used to be near enough 15 stones. So I've lost a stone. I'm on the championship fight. I'm the championship weight. 14 stone first and 14 stone now. What happened? What I'm wasting.
There might be a cruiserweight prize fighter coming up soon.
Oh boy. You know, I see the cruiserweight now. Only the top people will finger their kind of punches and all that, and I still think I can do damage in the cruiserweight, because the talent is so little. There's not many great talent in the cruiserweight on up in the top. So yeah, it just makes you want to think, but obviously my time's gone. It's past. I've accepted it. It's finished. I was surprised that when, like I said, when Frank Warren got on the phone to me and said, hey, how would you like to fight Chris Eubank? And I thought, well, can I make cruiserweight? And he said he thinks he can. And but I like that one, that's going ching in my head, ching, yeah, I'm in the money. Like, well, it wasn't that case. I wasn't going to get, he was a draw. I was just there for him to beat me, really, basically. That's the way I looked at it. But there was no way I was going to let Chris beat me, because it's, he moved up. Well, I couldn't hold my head up in the street. He managed to take his best shot. And that's what he didn't bank on, me taking his best shot and coming at him and making him work. I'm a type of fighter, so if you don't put me down, I will always come at you. And he was tired. I just drained him, and he was there for the taking. And I took him. and I broke him. And what's baffling me, David Haye, why never they approached me for a rematch? Why? Because I would have ruined him, and he would have never gone out and achieve what he ever achieved. I felt robbed. I felt robbed. I felt cheated. And it took me a long time to forgive Johnny Nelson. I knew it wasn't his fault. There's people behind him. Wrong.